Today's class is formulas related to resistor and capacitor inductor. So we'll start with resistor. So resistor, first letter R. That's why letter R indicates resistor. The symbol is like this. So when we are applying voltage source V through this resistor R, current I is flowing. So resistor symbol always two peaks up, two peaks down. Three peaks up, three peaks down also okay. So always show the symbol properly. So in this I is equal to V by R and V is equal to IR. R is equal to V by I. So here I is the current. Units are amps. So first letter A. And this V is voltage. Voltage drop. Voltage drop. So it is volts. First letter V. Then R is the resistor, V by I, ohms. Ohms. But first letter is O. O is not used because O is already used for oxygen shortage of letter. But they are using different notation. So this is the symbol for ohm. Why they are using this kind of shape? What is resistor is opposing. Opposing the current. So to climb this hill, it is difficult, na? It is opposing. So going higher side is difficult. It opposes. So this symbol behave, or this symbol speak the behavior of the resistor. That's why they selected this symbol for ohm. But this word ohm came from the Ohm's law. Ohm's law, ohm is a scientist name that is used for resistor unit. Similarly, capacitor, Faraday, Faraday's laws. So that Faraday, capacitor unit, Faraday. Inductor units, Henry. Henry is a scientist, Faraday is a scientist, ohm is a scientist. So without any partiality, scientist names are used for resistor, capacitor and inductor. Then we'll take up power P. P is equal to V into I. Watts. So watts with W. Then energy. Energy is always power into time. So many joules. So again first letter J. Here first letter used, here also first letter used. What is the meaning, what is the difference between power and energy? Power is always calculated at given time, but energy calculated over duration of time. For example, in DC analysis, voltage is constant. Current also constant. Then how to find power P power is nothing but voltage into current. Two constant product is also constant. But how we are finding energy? Energy we are finding multiplying power with time. For example, in this time gap, I want energy. That means what? We multiply power, this height multiplied with this width. So what is height into breadth or width is area. So this product will give area. Therefore, we say area under power curve is nothing but energy. Area under power curve is always energy. So we can do comfortably multiplication because power is constant. But what happens in AC analysis? In AC analysis, voltage changing with the time. Now I am using small v of t, value changing with the time. Then current also changing with the time, I of t. Then power also changing with the time. Power also changing with time. Now to find energy, you can't multiply power into time. This multiplication will not give area because power is changing with time. Now integrate. Integrate from 0 to where you are interested, 0 to t, then small p of t dt. So this will give what? Area under power. Area under power is energy. So energy is calculated always over a duration of time. Power is calculated always at a given time. Example, how much loudly I am speaking at a given time is a power. How long I can speak loudly is my energy. So energy is over a duration. Power is always at a given time. You go by integration if quantity changing with time. You just do multiplication if it is constant. Even if it is constant, if you integrate, you get same answer. But when it is varying, if you multiply, you get wrong answer. Varying, compulsory integration. Constant, you can multiply, you can also integrate. So this is energy concept in AC analysis and DC analysis. So these are the different formulas. Formula 1, Formula 2, Formula 3, Power Formula 4. This formula can be modified further. I square R or V square by R. Using this Ohm's law, you can change into I square R, V square by R. But when it is V square by R, V must be voltage drop across resistor. This V must be across R, not the source. So V square R, I square R, VI. All three will give same answers. To calculate power in the source, you have to use only this. To calculate power in the element, you can use any one of the formula, or even you can use this also. If you know current and voltage, you can also use this. So resistor, three formulas we can apply, same answer. But for source, you have to apply only VI. So this is formula 4. This is 5th formula, 6th formula. Energy, 7th formula. Here integration, 8th formula. Then resistor value depends on rho L by A. So this is a 9th formula. So all these formulas you should remember and apply when there is a resistor. So in all these formula, which is important formula is this. This is Ohm's law. This is only Ohm's law. From this Ohm's law, we derived all other things. This you have to believe. Then all other derived formulas also you should believe. And all other concepts derived from this. This is the law. So this is a brief summary of all the formulas related to resistor. Similarly, what are the formulas for capacitor? Capacitor first letter C, so C is used, but what is the symbol is this. Why that symbol is used? Because capacitor means plates concept. So this is the preferred symbol. To this capacitor, when V is applied, when source V is applied, then charge will be developed. That charge is Q. And what is the relation? V is equal to Q by C. This is the important formula. Justification for this I have given last class, that is first class. Water level, quantity, container width, that physical concept explained, pictorial view of Ohm's law. This you have to believe. This is important. This you remember it. From this we obtain all the other formulas. What is this capacitor keyword? Capacitor, capacity. So it's a storing element. Because it is a storing element, that word came, capacitor, capacity. Now from this, V is equal to, what is charge? Current into time. Current into time by C. The second formula. Current into time. If current is constant with the time, so current into time, this will give what? Area. Area under current is charge. Area under current is charge. Area under power is energy. But if current is changing with time, current is changing with time, small I of t. So how to find area under this when it is changing with time? We have to integrate. How to integrate? Now V of t is equal to 1 by C integral 0 to t, integral 0 to t, this t can be any value, and I of t and dt. So this is voltage form, this is current form, sorry, this is integral form, this is multiplication form. We use this for DC, we use this for AC. But if I differentiate both, I of t equal to C dV by dt. C dV by dt. This is a derivative form. This is derivative form. This is integral form. Whenever I am writing V, it is like a V of t or Vc of t. Vc of t. Or only small v. Anything, all right. So therefore, this is the basic formula 1. From this we got this. From this we got this. Differentiate both these sides, we get this. The same way, how to find the power? Power P of t is equal to V of t into I of t. Then energy is integral P of t dt. Integral V of t. P of t is what? V of t into I of t. But I of t I can replace with this. So that is C dV by dt into dt. So dt cancel. C is a constant outside. V dV. So integrate V with respect to V. What you get? V square by 2. So this is nothing but C V square by 2. So normally how we write? E C of t, energy in capacitor as a function of time, E C of t equal to half C V of t square. This is important formula. So what is the inner meaning of this formula? Energy stored in capacitor at any given time depends on voltage at that time. Means if voltage is fixed with time, energy also fixed. If voltage in the capacitor is changing with our real time, energy stored also changes. This is correct way of writing, but lazy way of writing. Our shortcut writing is half CV square. So whenever I am writing E equal to half CV square, take meaning like this. This is the short form notation. This is the correct way of writing. So this is formula 5th. What is 6th formula is capacitor value. This capacitor value depends on epsilon A by D. This we discussed in first class. D is the distance between plates. A is the overlapping area. Overlapping plate area, not area between overlapping plates. So this is a 6th formula. We can also derive this, but not now, later we see. So this formula, remember. So out of all these 6 formulas, this you remember, then all other will come automatically. Capacitor store energy. Capacitor store static energy. Why this word static came? Stationary. Which is stationary? Energy depends on voltage, na? Voltage is not moving, current is moving. That's why it store energy. Capacitor always store. What is the best example for capacitor? Mobile phone battery, car battery, inverter battery, and human body, stomach. Stomach is also like a capacitor. So it store energy. Whenever you want, you can use it. But whereas resistor dissipate energy. Resistor always dissipate what? Energy. Resistor dissipate energy. Dissipate means once dissipated you can't bring it back, but when it is storing you can bring it back, we can reuse it. Capacitor is a storing element, resistor is a dissipate. Dissipated power or energy converted to heat, converted to heat, temperature. But resistor, no. So these are the formulas related to capacitor. So capacitor units are farads. So we use F, small f or capital F. And charge units are coulombs. Capacitor, farads. This is volt. And other units you are aware of it. So these are the formulas for capacitor. So as I said in first class, this is compared with what? Water level. This charge is compared with what? Quantity. This capacitor value is compared with any container width. Container width. Container width. Container can be drum or bucket or mug, anything. So that width is comparable with the capacitor value conceptually. And now this is charging, that concept we discussed in first class. So these are the formulas applicable to capacitor. Then third and last element is inductor. Best example for capacitor to understand is bucket. You ask any doubt related to capacitor, bucket will answer. So bucket is best example. But inductor, it is not so easy, not like a bucket. Inductor. Inductor, first letter I, but I is not used. Letter L is used. Symbol is this. Why inductor I is not used? I is already used for current. So I cannot be used for inductor. Inductor L is used. But why letter L is used? If you observe the carefully, tongue movement, inductor, tongue movement, read the letters from A to Z, four letters tongue movement is similar to tongue movement of inductor pronunciation. Out of four letters, three already used for a different purpose. Left over is only L. L, tongue movement, inductor tongue movement is matched. That is the reason why letter L is selected for inductor. Why this word inductor came? Induction, induced. Something generating. Something is generating. So induced, principle used is induced. Induction, something generated. That's why it is called as a, that word came, inductor, induction. So that's how this word came. So letter L. Here coil principle is involved, so that is a symbol. But how this is working? Based on four important points. What is the, those laws are Faraday's first law. What is Faraday's first law? Whenever conductor cuts the stationary magnetic flux, or varying magnetic flux cuts the stationary conductor, an EMF is induced in conductor. There are two things. One is conductor, other side magnetic flux. If any one is changing, then voltage will induce in the conductor. Whether conductor is cutting the flux or flux is cutting conductor, voltage will come in conductor only. So that is the basic principle, first law. Second law, the quantity of EMF depends on quantity, magnitude, how much voltage will come. That depends on what? Rate of change of flux linkage, not leakage, flux linkage. So using Faraday's second law, V is equal to N d phi by dt. What is this phi? Is the flux. It is a magnetic flux. D phi by dt is rate of change. Multiplying with N. N is the number of turns. So induced EMF, quantity of EMF depends on rate of change of flux linkage. It's multiplying na linkage. So N and d phi by dt decide the value of V. This is as per Faraday's second law. Faraday is once again scientist name. Third one, right hand rule. What is that right hand rule says? Look at this. This is a core, my magnetic core, winding with the copper wire. I can wind this core with a copper wire. So when I am sending current from here, so current will go around again, come back. Or I can also do like this. So current go like this, again come back. What is right hand rule is, you keep your right hand, these four fingers indicate the, not four finger, four, F-O-U-R, four fingers indicate current direction in the coil. So when I am winding core with the coil in this direction, when I send current here, current will go in the coil like this. So these four finger indicates current direction in the coil. When current is flowing in the coil, then this magnetic core become magnet. Magnetic core change to magnet. Then any magnet will produce what? Flux. Flux is not stationary, flux always flow. So the direction of the flux flow we can easily determine with the help of right hand rule. So what is this rule says? Four fingers indicate the current direction in the coil, thumb indicates the flux direction. This is one way of winding. If it is in a reverse direction, then hold like this, then thumb is this side, flux will go this side. This is a right hand thumb rule. What is the use of this rule? It helps us to decide which direction flux is flowing with the help of thumb. So right hand thumb rule. What is the use of Faraday's second law? How much voltage is coming? What is the use of Faraday first law? When voltage will come? Under what condition voltage is coming? How much voltage is coming? Then right hand rule is flux direction. Then fourth one is Lenz law. Lenz law says, when voltage is coming, which side positive, which side negative, we don't know. So Lenz law is another scientist. It helps us to determine induced EMF, which side positive polarity, which side negative polarity. That we can determine with the help of Lenz law. So Lenz law says, whatever EMF is induced opposes the cause which is producing. EMF is inducing. Whatever EMF is induced opposes the cause which is producing. That's what Lenz law. Now these four apply on the coil, then understand the functionality of inductor. So we are taking a core. It's an iron core. There are different types of core materials are there. This is one of the core. Then this is winding with copper wire. Now apply voltage source. Here one important is we have to apply AC voltage source only. AC voltage source. DC voltage, DC current, DC flux. Derivative of DC become zero voltage. Voltage will not induce. So compulsorily we have to apply AC voltage only. Then current will flow. That current is also AC, na? So I of T. This is the current direction. This is the current direction. So if this is the current direction, use your right hand rule. Thumb indicates flux, na? So which direction flux is flowing? This direction flux is flowing. This flux will not flow like this. It has to come back again. So this is the direction of flux. As long as current is positive, a varying current positive, later negative current. What is AC voltage? AC voltage means voltage positive, negative, current is also positive, then negative will come. During negative, current direction will change, na? If this is changed, here also changed, na? If here is changed, flux direction also change. Flux direction also change. So please understand, if voltage is changing positive, negative and so on, current also changing positive, negative and so on, flux developed also positive clockwise direction, negative anti-clockwise direction. So flux is clockwise then anti-clockwise. So whatever flux is induced is changing with time. Voltage changing with time, current changing with time, flux induced also changes with time. So that is the flux. Now the total flux is psi. There is a Telugu movie, Psi. Psi indicates total flux. Total flux is equal to n into phi. What is phi? Flux due to one turn. Flux due to one turn. Only one turn. But how many number of turns are there? N. N into phi will give total flux indicated with psi. Therefore, psi is equal to N into phi. If I differentiate d psi by dt, what I get? N d phi by dt. But as per Faraday's second law, N d phi by dt is what? V. When this is V, what is the conclusion? D psi by dt is also equal to V. So this is another derivation. Also remember, the total flux developed is psi. But this total flux is proportional to I, na? Without current, you don't get flux. So flux induced is proportional to current I. The total flux psi induced is proportional to current I. But when I remove this proportionality, some constant L into I, then d psi by dt. d psi by dt is what? L di by dt. But here what we got? D psi by dt equal to V na. So here also d psi by dt is equal to V. Therefore we got another formula. What is that formula? V equal to L di by dt. So this is another important formula. Now there are two versions. One is V equal to N d phi by dt. Other V equal to L di by dt. If I equate these two, dt dt will go. Then L is equal to N d phi by di. This is also equal to N phi by I. Don't think these are cancelled. Change in flux with respect to change in current. As long as core is not saturated means current increasing, flux increase, current increase, flux increase. At one stage, current increase but flux will not increase. Why? It is saturated. So what I am telling, as long as core not saturated means within the linearity, d phi by dt I can also write it as phi by sorry d phi by di I can also write it as phi by I. But what is n into phi is psi na, so psi by I. So L equal to psi by I. But we don't remember this form L equal to psi by I. We remember this form. I is equal to psi by L. This form we remember. Why remember this form? What is voltage in capacitor? V is equal to Q by C na. So C is in the denominator. For resistor, I is equal to V by R. R is in the denominator, C is in the denominator, inductor is in denominator. So here from this formula, we derived so many. From this, we derived so many. But this we derived from other laws. That is the basic difference. So I can give numbers. So this may be formula 1, V equal to L di by dt, formula 2. You can also get integral form. This is derivative form, integral form. What is integral form? I is equal to 1 by L integral V dt. Integrate both sides, you get this. Limits 0 to t. T can go up to infinite also. So we got this from this third formula. Then this is fourth formula, total flux. V equal to N d phi by dt. Fifth form. Sixth one, like power, P of t is equal to V of t, I of t. Then energy equal to integral P of t dt. So similar to capacitor, if you substitute and integrate, you get another beautiful formula, E L of t of L I of t square. So what is the meaning? Energy stored, again this is also storing element. Energy stored in inductor at any given time depends on current at that time. But here it is stored in the form of current. Current is deciding energy, capacitor voltage is deciding the energy. Therefore, inductor stores dynamic energy. It store dynamic energy. What is the keyword here? Dynamic. Capacitor, what is the keyword? Static. Capacitor is a storing element, inductor is also storing element. So whatever voltage we are getting here with this polarity, it is inducing. When current flowing through this coil, voltage is induced. Induction, inductor. So how much voltage will induce depends on L value. But L value again depends on, this L value depends on mu A N square by L. There is a another derivation, this we study later. That is like resistor value depends on rho L by A, capacitor value depends on epsilon A by D, like that inductor value also depends on mu A N square by L. But what is this mu? Mu is the permeability. This mu is the permeability. Permeability of the core. What is the meaning of permeability? When current is flowing in this coil, flux is coming. This flux is passing through core, na? So it's a behavior of the core. Core, ability of the core to permit the flow of flux. That's why it's a permeability. It's a behavior of the core. So different cores will have a different mu. Mu is the permeability. Then A is what? Cross-sectional area of the core. If you imagine this is like a core, this is the cross-sectional area. Cross-sectional area of the core is A. Then this N is already discussed, number of turns. So number of turns always equal to N. Then what is this L? L, is it length of coil or length of the core? One of the year IES exam they asked this question. This L is length of the core or length of the coil. If you see the Google, some answers will come as length of the coil, some answers will be length of the core. You ask 100 teachers, 50% will tell length of the core, 50% will tell length of the coil. You can't blindly believe the Google. You also cannot believe books available. Again, some book behind, who is there? Again, author. Author means again teacher. So you can't believe blindly any book. You can't believe blindly Google. You can't believe any teacher blindly also. That's where experience play important role. So what is this L is? Length of the core, not length of the coil. If this coil is winding done, entire core, then length of the coil remains same. But not necessarily, na? A coil can be only at same place. So in that case, it is not length of the, not the physical length. I am talking about the from which point to which point coil is winding done. So that is the coil length I am talking. From this end to this end is a core length. So L is the core length, not coil length. If coil is starting from here to here, then if you use word coil length, it is same. But basically you have to focus as length of the core, not length of the coil. Length of coil is subset of length of core. So you should tell as length of core. So this is L. So mu A N square by L, decide the value of L. So core is easily permitting the flow of flux. Mu increasing, L increasing. Cross sectional area, bigger core, flux easily flowing. Then L increase. You have a more number of turns, more flux induce. So that also encourage L. But if it has to travel longer distance, then inverse relation. This is inductor value, this is the length of the core. This is inverse, but this is directly related. So that is what L. This one is sixth formula. So capacitor, inductor, six formulas. Capacitor also six formulas. Resistor, nine formulas. So these are the different formulas for resistor, capacitor, inductor. Resistor dissipate, capacitor and inductor store. Capacitor store static energy, inductor store dynamic energy. And inductor principle, this kind of mechanism is involved, na? That's why this is the symbol. The symbol speak inductor. So there is a coil mechanism is there. That's why like this. You can make three rounds, enough. Don't make so many rounds. So this is the symbol. This is the symbol. This is the letter used. That is the name of it, inductor. And also if you observe with capacitor or compare with the capacitor, capacitor, what is the voltage formula? 1 by C integral I dt. Inductor, what is the formula? I is equal to 1 by L integral V dt. In this, I is equal to C dV by dt. In this, V equal to L di by dt. So capacitor, inductor, they are dual to each other. Dual means voltage is dual of current, or current is dual of voltage. So capacitor voltage formula, inductor current formula similar. Capacitor current formula, inductor voltage formula similar. Voltage current dual, voltage current dual, capacitor inductor dual. If you remember capacitor formulas, automatically you can remember inductor formulas. Capacitor, if you integrate current, you are getting voltage. Inductor, if you integrate voltage, you are getting current. So this is the, if you compare, what are the differences? So with this, what we studied, a basic formulas related to resistor, capacitor and inductor. Thank you.